we've been dealing with basically is we've been getting pushed into the core level of our inner wounding. Now,
yeah.
all of us have that. All of us have a core level of wounding within. And
oh, yeah.
This is something that I've written so much about because I've written so much about Chiron. And Chiron
yeah.
is the planet, is the body in the solar system that rules accessing core wounding. So in my own work in catastrophophobia and with Chiron, I've worked with the idea that the core wounding for our species at the current moment is coming from the series of cataclysms around 12,000 years ago. And some people may know of those cataclysms as the fall of Atlantis. Some people think of it as the fall of Atlantis, whatever it is. But we do have a global mythology of a fall from a higher state of civilization, and we're
yeah.
rebuilding ourselves. We're coming back up from that point in time. But psychologically, this functions as the core wound. Like, think of yourself as being like an onion, and in the very center of that onion, you've got that core wound. And
yeah.
then you've got all those layers over it that represent past lives and childhood trauma or whatever they are. And so the idea here would be that for the last 10 months, 10, 11 months, we've been pushed into that level of core wounding, and that most people who are tuned in at all have been dealing with very deep levels of pain and very deep levels of core consciousness, and they're working at healing themselves from that.
Yeah.
You know, so the idea would be that when day 7 comes and the cataclysmic wounding healing is complete, that then, just like with any healing, we'll reach that point where we'll just go like, I did it. And it'll be a massive movement. And so the astrology is showing that during September and October, we're all going to be dealing with the parts of the core pain and core wounding that we haven't dealt with so far. Different people are at different levels and at different places with this issue. Some people have
right.
done a lot of work. Some people have done a small amount of work. But the idea would be with the astrology seems to be saying, doesn't matter what you did, you're going to finish it. Which would mean for somebody who's been avoiding it, it will be very painful. And for somebody who's been doing the work, it'll just be more completion of this.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah. And astrology is really backing up that idea, because in order to go into the fruition phase, that painful dark night of the soul has to be complete.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Absolutely. And we have been releasing for some time now eons of trauma and his past history and Earth's core memories and the rest of it, haven't we, as we've been going along?
Yeah, and I came up with a really interesting idea to this morning that may give some perspective on the oil spill in the Gulf. If you go back through the evolutionary record of the evolution of mammals, which is about the last 800 million years. This in Kalaman system, this is the second underworld that he calls the mammalian underworld. And what happens with the mammalian underworld is we have 7 days and 6 nights, just like we have in every other underworld. And when we go back and examine the record, that this is the paleontological and biological record for the last 800 million years, we find that at each one of the days, day 1, day 2, day 3, so on and so forth, we find that there is an introduction of a new species of mammals. Like, say, take 330 million years ago, which happens to be, I think it's day 3. I don't have any of this data in front of me. But we see the introduction of fishes. Or we go back to 63 million years ago, and we find the extinction of reptiles and the beginning of placental animals. But the point, Lance, would be that there's always a cataclysm before the new stage comes in. So we have different extinctions, like the Cambrian extinction.
Uh-huh.
And what I was thinking about this morning is if you examine the data bank, you'll find that most of the extinctions occurred on land. When we go back and look at the different species, the species in the sea tended to not have extinctions the way we do on the land, because they were protected, I think, by from cosmic influences from the sky. I mean, a lot of the extinctions have been caused by meteors and pieces of supernovas and all that stuff that goes on in the sky. So one of the things I was thinking about this morning was it would appear that this time the extinction may be in the sea. See, I think this oil spill is huge in comparison to what most people think about what's going on.
Oh yeah. And intentionally that way.
Oh yeah. The global elite just wants business as usual. Just, you know,
right.
Go shopping. Yeah, exactly. Right. Go eat a shrimp dinner.
Right. Yeah, please go eat one right now.
Right. Nothing to worry about. We're checking all of the fish, and we're checking all of the shellfish and the mussels to make sure that there's no problem, right?
Oh, of course.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The sickness and perversity of the elite is just I don't know. I mean, it's almost laughable if it wasn't so despicable.
that leads me to another thought that I've just been having all of these big thoughts lately, which aren't necessarily always that pleasant because they aren't always positive, you know.
Right.
And
right.
I really, really love Avatar by James Cameron.
Me too.
Yeah, and so for me with Avatar, I've been cycling through different levels with it. I'm going to go see it again because I saw it when it first came out, but I'm going to go see it again. But, you know, the basic premise of Avatar is that U.S. military forces are attacking a small planet, Pandora, in order to get something they want, which happens to be that vibrating thing, whatever that was that they were... I forget what it was.
Oh, the Pandium.
Some sort of amazing element.
Yeah.
But what they were doing is that they were willing to even destroy Pandora in order to get what they want. Wouldn't you agree in the basic premise of the movie? Well,
yeah.
Sometimes I wonder. Now, notice Pandora. Notice they didn't win. First of all, that's important. They didn't destroy Pandora. But sometimes when I see what's going on with the Earth, it would appear that there's some sort of outside force almost that is willing to even destroy this place to get what it wants.
Oh,
and
absolutely.
I think that's another level with Avatar that at least I didn't think about when I saw it. I, for some reason, have only been thinking about this recently, that Cameron might have been trying to get us to start thinking about whether we're actually under attack from something from the outside. Do you see what I mean?
Oh, yes. I don't think there's any question about that.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, just for me personally, I think that we have been under attack for as long as I've been on the planet, which is not long.
Mm-hmm.
And if you look back at the history of mankind, I think you can see it from the very beginning of mankind and beyond that. So I think we've been under attack since the beginning, and we've never had a... with the exclusion of some very peaceful, maybe thousands of year periods of Egyptian rules, where the feminine has dominated, where you've had
so to move it to a more positive level.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I don't get into these negative things unless I can really. I usually don't figure them out until I can see a solution. You know, I'm like that as an astrologer. I would never say anything negative unless I could see the solution. If you see what I mean.
Thank you for pulling me out of the rut there.
Well, no. I mean, seriously, this is a topic I don't think I've ever brought up before, probably especially in public. But the reason I'm willing to talk about it is consider the following possibility.
Okay.
If this is what's going on, let's assume this is what's going on, then if you look at the way we're being treated at the current moment, the whole attack is based on the premise that the people on Earth won't realize that they're being attacked.
Uh-huh.
Wouldn't you agree? Everything is set up so that you're not supposed to know that this is going on.
Yes.
Meanwhile, if we look at the new consciousness movement and we look at all of the awareness that people are building on this planet, a whole lot of people are figuring this out, including possibly James Cameron.
Wouldn't
you think that we'd have the end of the game if people figured the game out?
Well,
you see what
sure.
I mean?
In other words,
as long as people are ignorant and can't see that something like this is going on, then even if that isn't the final step to getting out of, at least one of the steps to getting out of this would be to figure it out.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Of course, if I were on their side, I would be throwing up more smoke and mirrors and, you know, setting off a firebomb here and a virus over there and keep us so distracted that we didn't have time to figure it out. But they've been doing that, and we're still figuring it out.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So I think you're right. I think that we're beginning to see the man behind the curtain, and he may just be a pathetic little old wizened man that, you know, is pretty sad and pathetic.
Yeah,
you know,
and then the other side of this that I dealt with this in the Mayan code, there's another issue here, which would be the issue of exopolitics.
Oh, yeah.
And the issue of exopolitics is that Earth is under a quarantine because we're a violent and abusive species, and that if we wake up and stop being a violent and abusive species, then we're going to be back in cosmic connection, you know. In other words, the quarantine gets lifted, and then we become part of the Galactic Federation and the Universal Society and all of that kind of stuff, you know.
Yes.
So another thing the elite tries to do, and I'm really talking about this with you, trying to decode something here, if you know what I mean.
Okay.
Another thing the elite sets up is if you think that you're under attack from some kind of outside agency, then the first thing you're going to do is you're going to shut out any connection whatsoever with the cosmic connection.
Right.
You follow what I mean?
Yes,
so,
I do.
So we may be under attack by some squirrely little weirdo coming from some ex-planet out in some galaxy where they're trying to get something here because they're trying to survive.
Yeah.
You know, and then we could miss the fact that our protection is the cosmos itself. In other
That's
words,
right.
there's always going to be a bad guy here or there. You see
That's
what I'm
right.
getting at?
That's right.
I haven't really thought this whole thing through exactly, but I have a feeling it fits with some of the things that you think about, actually.
Well, you know, that would be a very good technique to throw us off, because then we'd be throwing the baby out with the bathwater, and all the elite have to do is just keep the pressure up that aliens are bad, they're out to get us, we've got to fight them, you know, they're going to eat us up for dinner. And,
like,
of course,
like that movie Signs, remember that one? The little green
man.
I mean, that type of thing. And that's what continually throws people off from just feeling comfortable about the goodness of the cosmos itself.
And we know, you and I know, that it's a benevolent cosmos, a loving cosmos, an organic and breathtaking creation that is here to serve us and cooperate and be with us. And, so all of this distortion, all of these distortion fields and negativity are not real.
Yeah, yeah. That's right.
But,
and then judging by this issue of night 6 and then day 7, because all of this cataclysmic consciousness and memory has been awakened, it's really moving us toward facing this and trusting that there's a good outcome coming here.
Yes. Now, what do you think about several of my guests and several others that I've read talk about the potential of an incoming flux of energies, and they call it, for instance, Robert Cox refers to this in his books as the pillar of...
When day 7 comes and the cataclysmic wounding healing is complete, but then, just like with any healing, we'll reach that point where we'll just go like, I did it. And it'll be a massive movement. And so the astrology is showing that during September and October, we're all going to be dealing with the parts of the core pain and core wounding that we haven't dealt with so far. Different people are at different, you know, levels and different. We've been dealing with basically is we've been getting pushed into the core level of our inner wounding. Now all of us have that. All of us have a core level of wounding within.
And this
is something that I've written so much about, because I've written so much about Chiron. And Chiron is the planet, is the body in the solar system that rules accessing core wounding. So in my own work in catastrophobia and with Chiron, I've worked with the idea that the core wounding for our species at the current moment is coming from the series of cataclysms around 12,000 years ago. And some people may know of those cataclysms as the fall of Atlantis. Some people think of it as the fall of Atlantis, whatever it is. But we do have a global mythology of a fall from a higher state of civilization, and we're rebuilding ourselves. We're coming back up from that point in time. But psychologically, this functions as the core wound. Like, think of yourself as being like an onion, and in the very center of that onion, you place us with this issue. Some people have done a lot of work. Some people have done a small amount of work. But the idea would be with the astrology seems to be saying, doesn't matter what you did, you're going to finish it, which would mean for somebody who's been avoiding it, it will be very painful. And for somebody who's been doing the work, it'll just be more completion of this.
Huh, interesting.
Yeah. And astrology is really backing up that idea, because in order to go into the fruition phase, that painful dark night, you've got that core wound. And then you've got all those layers over it that represent past lives and childhood trauma or whatever they are. And so the idea here would be that for the last 10 months, 10, 11 months, we've been pushed into that level of core wounding, and that most people who are tuned in at all have been dealing with very deep levels of pain and very deep levels of core consciousness, and they're working at healing themselves from that.
Yeah.
You know, so the idea would be that when